Welcome back, video creeps. It's that time again where we are going to take a trip back through time. You guys really dug my favorite movies of the 80s, where I talk about my favorite movies of that decade. So much that I decided I'm going to do it again. But this time we're moving forward through time, and I'm going to give you guys my favorite movies of the 90s. Now this list is a lot longer than my 80s video, so I'm not going to go into each one in too much detail, because if I do that, then this video will end up being like an hour long, but I will be touching on each and every single one. So without further ado, let's visit my favorite movies of the 90s. Basket Case. We see the return of Bilal and his brother, and I gotta say, this is probably my favorite Basket Case film of the trilogy. Especially with that ending. Oh, I fucking love that.
Wishmaster.
To go from Aladdin's genie to the Wishmaster genie, it's not an easy task. But we all gotta grow up sometime. But I tell you what, if that motherfucker thinks I'm gonna wish for his freedom, he has another thing coming.
Child's Play 2.
This is the quintessential Chucky film. I don't think I've ever met a human being who's like, oh, Child's Play 2? Fucking hate it. It's impossible.
Frankenhooker.
What can I say? I'm a big fan of Frank Henenlotter's films. I love the Basket Case films. I love Frankenhooker. I even love Bad Biology. And that movie is about a killer dick and vagina.
The Rage. Carrie 2.
I know people are gonna throw hate at me for this one, but what can I say? I have a soft spot. The girl who plays Carrie in this film is really fucking hot. And beyond that, I felt really fucking bad for her. Maybe even more so than I do for the original Carrie. Go figure.
Gremlins 2, The New Batch.
This movie is like Child's Play 2. It's just fucking impossible to hate this movie. They did so much right, and they offered you so much. There's something in this film for literally everybody.
Leatherface, The Texas Chainsaw Massacre 3.
I feel like in part 1 and 2, we definitely get to know the Sawyers a little bit, but in part 3, we really dig into that family dynamic. And I think this is where the series really starts to get its footing. It's also movies like Texas Chainsaw Massacre 3 that I think led to movies like House of a Thousand Corpses even existing.
Misery.
She loves hard. Who can hate a woman who knows what she wants? I'm into it.
The Craft.
Anytime, anywhere, I am always down to watch The Craft. And I'm a fucking idiot because it took me years to finally watch The Craft. Why am I an idiot? Because for some really stupid, sexist reason, I thought that The Craft was a chick film. But I can admit that I was an idiot for that. And The Craft is a fucking phenomenal movie.
The Blair Witch Project.
What can I say about The Blair Witch Project? I fucking love this movie. I will always be a fan of that franchise. Here's a fun fact. I drive a little 1995 Toyota Camry, and her name is Blair, named after this movie. So I'm serious.
Slumber Party Massacre 3.
The Return of the Driller Killer. I love this movie just as much as I love the first one. This is just an awesome slasher film from the 80s who just crawled its way into the 90s. but it has that same feel. Also, the chick in the blue little nightgown.
Necromantic 2.
This movie is not as insane as its predecessor, but I do think it's more entertaining. I know a lot of people didn't catch this one just because of like the nature of the film itself, but if you are not aware of the Necromantic films, do that.
The People Under the Stairs.
This movie made me terrified of people in my... What the fuck was that? The first time I saw this movie, I was really young and kind of basically forgot about it. Until my ex bought it for me and we sat down and watched it together, and it all came flooding right back to me.
Popcorn.
Loved Popcorn. This is one of those movies that I saw as a little kid as well, but completely even forgot. Like, you know those movies that you see as a kid, and then you remember bits and parts, but you don't remember the name, so you just spend the rest of your life Googling scenes, but it's lost in the fabric of time in your head, so you just never find that movie? This was that movie for me. Eventually, I did find it, and now I'm able to recognize it and put it on my list, but it took me years to find it. And when I did, I found it on fucking YouTube, like the whole movie.
Army of Darkness.
This is the Ash that we all grew to love and know. This is our fun Ash in his most amateur form. And I think this is when the guys who make Evil Dead really figured out what they wanted to do moving forward. As soon as Ash found himself as a character, so did the franchise. And I think we have Army of Darkness to thank for that.
Freddy's Dead, The Final Nightmare.
I know, people fucking hate this movie. But like I mentioned in my Nightmare on Elm Street review, this and the first one were the movies that I watched the most in that franchise. I don't know if it's just because it appeals to kids maybe, because it's a little goofy, it's kind of out there, there's the video game scene, it's really colorful, and like that trip scene. Something about it just appealed to the youth in me. Also, that thinking that this was going to be the last time that we would see Freddy, it's earned its place. And I think it's a great marker for the franchise in general.
Brain Scan.
This is Edward Furlong in his second best for me. First best will always be Detroit Rock City. But I love him in this movie, and it bums me out endlessly that this did not turn into a bigger franchise, because I think Jinx would have been one of the greats. If there's any one movie that I want to get a reboot or even a sequel if you can pull it off, it's fucking Brain Scan, man.
Candyman.
Who hasn't looked in a mirror in the middle of the night in a dark room, said Candyman three times? Just me? In all seriousness, I love Candyman, and I can't wait to see what Jordan Peele is going to do with the franchise.
Hellraiser 3, Hell on Earth.
This has always and will always be my favorite installment in the Hellraiser series. There's just something about seeing Pinhead in that block of souls and barbed wire just fucking gets me. Love that shit.
Pet Sematary 2.
It's no secret, I'm such a sequels guy. I love a good sequel. I love a movie, and then getting more of that movie. It's fucking pitch perfect. And that's exactly how I feel about Pet Sematary 2. I feel like it perfected the imperfections from part one. I'm a big fan of that.
I Know What You Did Last Summer.
Okay, look. My very first celebrity crush ever was on Jennifer Love Hewitt and fucking Can't Hardly Wait. So when the prospect of me being able to see her tits in a horror movie presented itself, oh, my ass was in the seat. She doesn't show her tits. But I still like the movie.
Bride of Chucky.
I tried to do this with no sequels on my list. I tried to hone in on one particular movie at a time. But I can't just ignore that Bride of Chucky came out in the 90s. It was too fucking good. It was like a gift. And I had just gotten old enough to really start getting excited about movies and shit. I was maybe like 9 or 10 when this came out. So I remember the trailer and being like,
Leprechaun.
I talk a lot on my channel about this first collection of horror movies that I had, and Leprechaun was one of the movies that were in it. I actually don't want to talk too much about Leprechaun just because I do want to review it in the near future, and I also want to make a video where I talk about that collection, because there's a couple in there, and I just really want to talk about them, because they're the movies that shaped me.
Curse of the Puppet Master.
Alright. Confession time, I was not a big fan of the Puppet Master movies. I didn't like part one, I thought it was too convoluted and weird for the time. I didn't like all the weird psychic, like, I just thought it was a fucking weird movie. So I kind of stayed away from the Puppet Master films. And then I watched Puppet Master 6. Six? I think it's six. Well, Curse of Puppet Master. And man, I fucking loved this movie. I loved it so much that I went back and started watching the other Puppet Master movies. And finally, I started to like them because I was such a fan of Chucky that I also wanted to like Puppet Master. It's like eating your favorite meal, but it's just served by somebody differently. And I'm so happy that I developed a taste because now I love Puppet Master. But I will always have a very special place in my heart for The Curse of Puppet Master.
Halloween, H2O.
Now, I know a lot of you might be asking yourself how the fuck this made it onto my list, and it's actually really simple. This is the first Halloween movie that I ever saw. I don't know how it happened this way, but it just did. So I understand that a lot of people watch this movie, and for them, it's Michael Myers at his worst. But this was my introduction to Michael Myers. So for me, watching the other Halloween films, he only got better. So I don't know, maybe I'm blessed to have watched it that way. And while I'm not a personal fan of Resurrection, maybe there's somebody who watched Resurrection for the first time and was like, this is why Michael Myers is cool. And I wouldn't be able to fault them for that. So for me, Halloween H2O is why Michael Myers is cool. So that's my list for right now. There's so many movies that came out in the 90s that I think I'm gonna make a second video down the line, revisiting this decade. I'm also gonna revisit the 80s, because again, just there's so much material that comes out. And as I'm watching and listening to recommendations, I'm always adding things to that list. But for right now, let's close the chapter on the 90s until my next video, where who knows, maybe we'll go to the 70s or the new millennium. I fucking know. But for now, keep in mind that I have not seen every single 90s movie, so if your favorite one did not show up on my list, don't be butthurt, my list is subjective. What you can do is mention it in the comments below. And as always, if you're not already, please subscribe and then hit the notification bell so that way you know when my next video is up. That's gonna be it for this one. Let's wrap it up again. Peace, video creeps.